Social media networks took center stage this week when they suspended the president's accounts. Twitter and others cited several posts that they say incited the riots. Now the debate on how these social media networks should be regulated has entered the mainstream. Here's Eyewitness News reporter Dan Koob.
It's been lurking for years, the discussion on how privately owned social media corporations like Twitter and Facebook should police their sites for objectionable or violent content.
We have left, you know, too much in the hands of the corporations themselves, and they can be doing things on a whim.
Dr. Frank Farley is a professor of psychology at Temple. Because there are no regulations for social media companies, he says small numbers of people are allowed to determine what can and can't be posted.
Your morality might not be the same as my morality, and therefore the people have to speak on this issue. It just can't be the individual corporations in their boardrooms making these decisions.
Should they have the power to decide who and who should not be heard, rather than representatives that have been democratically elected?
Temple Law professor Laura Little.
Is Twitter violating the Constitution when it says Trump cannot use its platform anymore? And the answer is, well, it's a little ambiguous because Twitter is a private entity and not the state government.
Google and Amazon removed the conservative social media app Parler from their servers until they say the developer creates monitoring systems for objectionable content. Both Farley and Little see this as an example of capitalism at work rather than censorship, one private corporation controlling another. However, both also think regulation in this space is not only necessary, but a matter of time. The question is, how much?
This is an opportunity to maybe clarify some of the real problematic issues in terms of what needs to be nailed down in terms of the reach of the Constitution and the reach of the power of social media.
Dan Koob, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
And keep it with CBS 3 and the CW Philly for continuing coverage of crisis at the Capitol. When we are not on TV, you can get the latest updates at CBSPhilly.com.